computer science engineering from IG-DTU, Kashmiri Gate. I have been placed at Microsoft IT. Not exactly placed, I got a PPO for my summer internship, and I have been offered a CTC of 18 lakhs per annum. I would like to thank Placement Board for taking this initiative, which would help our juniors to understand the placement procedure followed by various companies, and I hope by the end of this video you get a good insight about Microsoft. Microsoft is a multinational corporation which provides us with products like Windows, Azure, Xbox and many more which we use in everyday life. Microsoft IT is an internal branch of Microsoft, and Microsoft IT branch, which is situated in Hyderabad, is the largest operation branch outside America headquarters, that is in Redmond. So first of all, because I got a PPO, I will be explaining my procedure for getting an internship. So in internship, we first had a coding round for 65 minutes in which we had to code two questions which were based on the concept of data structure and algorithm. After the selection in the written round, or we call a coding round, we had the interviews which were divided into two parts. One was the technical part and the other was the HR part. In the technical interviews, the focus was on the projects that I had done by then, and the technical aspects of each project, and also the basic questions were asked in the areas of data structure, algorithm, operating system and DBMS. After that, I had an HR round, which was a kind of a problem solving kind of a round for me, because I was given a problem to create a system for a deaf person to communicate with sign languages, deaf and dumb person to communicate with sign languages to a normal person through a device. So I had to create that system. So after all this procedure, I got selected as an intern, and in Hyderabad I completed 2 months internship. At the end of the 2 months, I had again a PPO selection process to go through. In that, I had two interviews. The first interview was based on the project that I had done in that time period of internship. And in my internship, I had done two projects, and the whole interview moved around the technical aspects and the technologies that I had learned in that period. Then I had the second interview called the AA interview, where the major concern of the interview was to know whether I am suited for the role and my goals align with the goals of the company. So after these two interviews, I got selected and I got the PPO. Okay, so my tips and suggestions for you would be that be thorough with one language completely, whether it is C, C++ or Java. Be completely aware of all concepts of it. Also, focus on subjects like data structure, algorithm, operating system, DBMS and object-oriented programming, because these are the basic concepts which would help in both internship and your placement interviews. And from the interview point of view, always be confident, never be afraid. If you are afraid, the interviewer might take advantage of that and make you more nervous. Never be afraid. Also, never lie, always be frank whether you know the question or not. It's okay to not know, but never lie that you know, because he might round you up in a way that you can't come out of. Also, one more important thing, always think aloud. Whatever question they give you, always say and tell the person what you are thinking, so that the person gets to know, yeah, that this person has got the knowledge and he is capable enough to think in a way to solve a problem. In the interview, the first thing that the interviewer sees is your resume. Your resume should be short, concise, and should highlight your strong points in a way that they should appear the moment the person looks at your resume. For example, you have done many projects in hardware or software, whatever. So they should be at the top of your resume, just after your basic profiling, and they should be bold bolded and italic so that the person gets to know, yeah, you have done so many projects, and he could question that. That way you can shift the focus from interviewer's domain to your domain. So you are making it more advantageous for you. And it would help you get a good interview. And always remember to ask for suggestions and feedbacks at the end of interview. It gives a very positive feedback to the interviewer that yeah, this person is ready to learn and gain knowledge. I hope you gained a lot of knowledge from this interview. Please type your queries in the comment section below and subscribe to Placement Interview channel, which is the official YouTube channel for placement mode, and also like the video. Thank you and all the best.